New tonight, microchipping. It's a popular way to keep track of pets, but would you microchip yourself?
With a swipe of your hand, it would allow you to unlock doors, turn on lights, even log on to your cell phone. It's called biohacking. And as CBS 4's Vanessa Borge reports, it's happening right here in South Florida.
We live in a digital world filled with computers, cell phones, even fitness trackers. Humans now use technology for everyday conveniences by learning how to hack life.
You kind of barely see it.
Chrissy Heishman is implanted with a tiny, low-frequency microchip. The process is called biohacking. You've seen it before in movies.
This may be a little uncomfortable.
But science fiction is now reality. Why would someone do this? Heishman says to end the hassle of carrying a security badge at work.
So I'd be swiping this thing every time I went in, and you know, a lot of times I'm carrying a bunch of stuff and it was really inconvenient.
So with just a wave of her now bionic hand, Heishman gets the green light, her identity scanned and verified. Carlos Maldonado is chipped now too, but this implant is different. It communicates with his cell phone and other gadgets by simply touching them.
I'm a pretty tech-savvy person, telling me that I could pretty much get onto electronics with ease. I thought it'd be a pretty cool thing.
He can use it to keep his car locked too. With wireless technology shrinking, microchipping is becoming more mainstream. But getting implanted isn't happening in a doctor's office or even at a hospital. This experience is offered to body modification clients at tattoo and piercing shops like this one in Coconut Grove.
I think it's the future of these microchips implants. You know, and it's the simplest thing to do.
Noel Garcia is among very few people in the country performing this procedure. How is it legal to do something like this at a piercing shop?
It's no different than getting a shot, a flu shot, because it's really basic body piercing techniques.
He says he's done about a dozen in the past couple of years. Anyone can buy the implants and the syringe from dangerousthings.com.
Most of our customers kind of understand what they're doing, and they understand the risk.
Amal Grafstra runs the Seattle-based company. He says business is booming.
Our devices are non-medical in nature. They're used for all kinds of identity applications. So access control, getting in your house, logging into your computer, that kind of thing. And it has nothing to do with medical. So it doesn't fall under the requirements of the FDA to be medically approved.
Which is exactly why people like Noel can do this legally with no questions asked.
This particular microchip implants is personal, like piercing.
But keep in mind, you'll have to get your own chip online. It costs about $75 to $150 for the implantation process, depending on the type of chip and where you want it implanted. Vanessa Borge, CBS 4 News.